One of the other really terrible things about this bill is that it will basically give the governor and his Department of Health Services pick the ability to unilaterally overrule Wisconsin law and dismantle our healthcare system in Wisconsin. Right now, we should be proud that we have the number one healthcare quality of all the states in the United States. And we're number two in terms of access, people's ability to get healthcare. And that's because of the laws that legislatures in the past have made. I'm very proud to have been a part of expanding programs like Badger Care and Senior Care that have been built up over time. Now the governor wants to destroy those in one fell swoop without any debate or democracy.
Were you one of the ones that fled out of the state?
Our Democratic colleagues in the Senate left the state because they decided they did not want to engage in sham democracy. They wanted to make sure that the public had time to learn about this bill, and they were not going to participate in seeing it just rammed through. So I'm very grateful to them that they have given the public an opportunity for their voice to be heard. They've given the Democrats in the Assembly, of which I'm one, the opportunity for our voices to be heard. We really wouldn't have had that chance had they not taken that courageous step to leave the state.
Anything else you'd like to add?
I just want people to understand that this is not about money. This is about people's rights. This is about democracy. And we've seen that the Republicans will stop at nothing. They will take illegal votes. They will break assembly rules and over 100 years of tradition. They will just do anything to pass this radical agenda to strip people of their rights. And I'm going to fight, and I know my Democratic colleagues in the Assembly and the Senate are going to continue fighting this for as long as we possibly can. We're very, very grateful that the people have come out and given us the opportunity to speak on their behalf.